Hello, friends. So, I wanted to do a live taste test. I just bought a few vegan treats from a local Mexican bakery. Now, if you are Latin or you come from a Latin community, you know, maybe even if you don't, you might know about pan dulce. Come on, come on, come on, go ahead. Comment or message me. Tell me what was your favorite pan dulce or your favorite memory of pan dulce. Maybe you had a least favorite and a really bad memory. Okay, for me, I had great memories growing up. I mean, my grandma was from El Salvador. My mom came to this country when she was 18. You know, I have a history of having that part of my life. And we used to go to a local, you know, there's some local, you know, Latin markets, Mexican markets, and they would have just like a regular grocery store, they would have a little bakery section, and that would be my favorite section, man. I used to like the big cookie with the rainbow sprinkles, or like the big cookie with the chocolate chips, or like I loved the ones with sesame seeds or the conchas. Back then, I didn't know what they were called. I just like described them. I was like, oh, I want that one with the white stuff or the sprinkle one. I didn't know the proper names. You know, what's awesome about this time in our society, in our world, is it's a coming together of a lot of different things. And what's really cool is that now you can find some of your childhood cultural favorite foods. And, you know, the demands for a little bit healthier options is here. And so we can find better options, but not compromise our memories or our favorite foods. So I never bought anything from this market before. It's called Delicias. Anyways, it's a regular, you know, pan dulce bakery, but then they also have a great selection. It's not just one. Sorry, I had a call. It's not just one vegan option. They have like two cases of different vegan pan dulces, and then they also have a whole like refrigerated section where they have vegan empanadas, vegan pupusas. No, not pupusas. Tortas. What else do they have? Like I don't know what they're called exactly, but but they're like tortillas, but they're kind of like tacos, but the tortillas are like folded and then like fried. And then they have they even have vegan queso fresco. Okay, that was my shit. When I was little, my grandma would just heat up some tortillas and just cut a piece of queso fresco, and we just eat that. I mean, like I said, a lot of what I ate as a child wasn't the healthiest, but I did love it. And then what else did they have? They had different desserts. They had flan, but it was made with coconut milk. They just had a lot of cool stuff, and I just got a few things today, so I thought I would try them live. And yeah, so okay, I got some pan dulce. Yeah, girl, it's not the healthiest, just to tell you. but I wanted to try it. And then I also got the little crispy, I don't know what you call them, I don't know, but it comes with green salsa, and then they also heat them up for you. And so I asked them to be heated up. I guess taquitos, what am I saying, people? Did I really forget about taquitos? So these have potato and soy rito. So I'm gonna try these. There's three of them in there. Now, I didn't ask if the tortillas were non-GMO or organic. I should have asked that. And I didn't ask if the soy riso was non-GMO or organic. So just a heads up, full disclaimer, you really need to be careful about corn and soy products. Always make sure that they're at least non-GMO. Organic would be best, but I was just so excited to try these. I didn't even ask. Those are good. Love it. Not too spicy. And then I got some empanadas. Now, these are more like a Cuban food because I didn't eat these growing up, but I did try them before, funnily enough, at my eating disorder treatment center. It was one of our fear foods. But I really liked them. And these ones, you get two of them. Oops, I spit. You get two of them. And the vegan ones have, I think if I remember correctly, tomato, sweet peppers, onions, potatoes, something else. But here we go. So the first bite is mostly just the bready part. Make sure to chew it very well. Otherwise, it's not going to really digest once you swallow it. Let me try it. Let me take another bite. Hopefully get more of the stuff. You know what it is? Kind of like a handheld. You know what it's like? It's like a calzone. If you watch Parks and Rec, everybody hates what's his name because he always brings up calzones. No, but those are good. I would say if I had to choose between which one, I would choose the taquitos. Now, they had different kinds of taquitos there. They had hibiscus ones, they had jackfruit, I think. So, most of their vegan options are kind of similar. They offer basically the same thing, but different stuff inside. What was I gonna do? Okay, so now we'll try the pan dulce. Of course, girl, of course, if I had all the money in the world, I would buy one of each, but that's not the case. Who's watching me? Hello, Oscar the Great. So I got, and again, like I said, I don't really know the names of them. But this one looked interesting to me. This one was the only one that, or one of the few that was not covered in sugar. I'm well aware that all of these have sugar in them, but I still want to be mindful, try to get a little bit better options. This one is actually made of corn, and they also have the same thing except in a donut shape. So I'm gonna try. I love corn, by the way. I love the texture. It's like a shortbread kind of cookie. Very good. Then I got a classic pan dulce, la concha. And I'm gonna show you some clips in my stories. But they had some really cute merchandise. Whoever did their merch was great because they had stickers that said, "Don't be self conscious." I thought that was so cute. I almost bought something. But yeah, I just got the vanilla one. They also had chocolate ones. I'm sure they had, or they do make strawberry. It just wasn't available when I went. So this is a classic. I always used to eat these when I was younger. Honestly, people, this tastes exactly like I remember it. You wouldn't even know it's vegan, girl. And then the last thing I got, my coffee is over there. Anyways, today is totally like a treat day. Don't worry. Tommy's making me vegetables and brown rice, so it balances out. Anyways, so the last one I got, I always used to like when I was younger, this kind with sesame seeds on them. Like I said, I never knew what they were called. I never really knew what was in them or anything. I just knew I liked the sesame kind. And so I saw a sesame thing, and she told me it's a quesadilla, that it actually has cheese in there. And I was like, this is what it looks like. Great angle, girl. She said, that has cheese inside. And I said, wait a minute, girl. It's still vegan, right? And she said, yeah. So, I'm gonna take a bite right now. Or maybe I could just break it and see. Oh, you know what? I think it's just like baked in there. You know what I mean? Like, I know there's some Asian pastries that's like the cheese is like baked in there, you know? So it's not really like cheesy, it's just like baked in there. Seems like a mighty long time. Exactly how I remember it. So good. So, if you're ever in the area, Los Angeles area, check out Delicia's on Figueroa. So good. You will not be disappointed. You can find all your childhood favorites veganized. 5 stars. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. Think differently.